الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وآله وصحبه. أما بعد، in سورة الأحقاف, the sand dunes, chapter 46, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us a very interesting parable, comparison between two sons, two different individuals. One was very kind to his parents, and when he reached the age of 40, he said a special prayer. And the other one was so unkind, and he insulted his parents, and he denied the resurrection and denied the one true God. So let me start from verse 15. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وصينا الإنسان بوالديه إحسانا. We have enjoined on man kindness to his parents. حملته أمه كرها ووضعته كرها. His mother carried him pain upon pain and delivered him in pain. وفصاله 30 شهرا. And it takes 30 months for his for the pregnancy and the weaning. The total is 30 months. حتى إذا بلغ أشده وبلغ 40 سنة. Then when he reaches his age of his full strength, and he reaches the age of 40 years, he says, My Lord, قال ربي أوزعني أن أشكر نعمتك التي أنعمت علي وعلى والدي وأن أعمل صالحا ترضاه وأصلح لي في ذريتي إني تبت إليك وإني من المسلمين. My Lord, enable me, empower me to give thanks to you for all your favors which you bestowed on me and on my parents, and help me to do the righteous deeds which you will be pleased with. And please make my offsprings, make my children and grandchildren righteous. Inni tubtu ilayk, I turn to you in repentance, and I submit my will to your will as a Muslim. So this is the good son who admits the favors which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed on him and his parents, and he's praying for Allah to accept him and to accept his deeds and to make his children and his offsprings and grandchildren righteous, and to admit him to his righteous servants. On the other hand, we are talking about a different one in verse 17. والذي قال لوالديه أف لكما. This is a man who said to his parents, to hell with you. أتعدانني أن أخرج وقد خلت القرون من قبلي. Are you telling me I'm going to come back to life again after all these generations has already passed before me? وهما يستغيثان الله ويلك آمن إن وعد الله حق. And the parents are seeking the help of Allah and asking the son to believe, inna wa'ad Allah haqq, the promise of Allah is the truth. And what is the response of the son? فَيَقُولُ مَا هَذَا إِلَّا أَسَاطِيرُ الْأَوَّلِينَ. This is nothing but the tales of the ancient. And unfortunately, such are they against whom the word proved true among the previous generations of jinn and men that have passed away, for they will be utterly lost. أولئك الذين حق عليهم القول في أمم قد خلت من قبلهم من الجن والإنس إنهم كانوا خاسرين. So the first one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted أولئك الذين تقبلوا عنهم أحسن ما عملوا ونتجاوز عن سيئاتهم في أصحاب الجنة وعد الصدق الذي كانوا يعدون. Such are they from whom we shall accept the best of their deeds and pass by their ill deeds, they shall be among the companions of the garden, a promise of truth which was made to them in this life. And in the footnote, a godly man often has an ungodly son. He flouts all that the father held sacred and looks upon his father himself as old fashioned and unworthy of respect or regard. The contrast is an individual family may be matched by the contrast in the passing and the rising generations of mankind. All this happens as a passing phase in the normal evolution of mankind, and there is nothing in this to be despondent about.
أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين فاستغفروه إنه غفور رحيم.